Tima Bumutter and Dennis Nazaroff over there.
Okay. Welcome to the floor for questions.
Coach, general thoughts?
It was an exciting game. We scouted them and we understood how they played soccer. They tend to kick long balls for the most part. So we just played our game and we tried to keep the ball on the ground and try to attack and keep the pressure on them and pressure them high because we knew defensively they'd just kick the ball right back to us if we did so.
Okay, one of the things defensively, you broke up a lot of their plays, especially in the middle, and it seemed like it kind of flustered them a little bit. Mm-hmm. That was, I'm going to guess that was part of the game plan. Your defense really.
Yes, we knew exactly the zones where their long balls go to, and our player that's in there, Alex Prokopenko, did an amazing job of stopping them attacking us. He broke up so much play.
Dennis, can you talk about the goal and really being a big part of history? First state title for Pikesville, and you're right in the middle of all the fun.
I mean, I saw Ben, he's the other centerman, he got the ball, and the center backs were giving me a lot of space to make a run through. So I just told Ben to play it through, he played it through, took a couple of bounces, and I looked for a corner and scored.
What's that feeling like?
I mean, it's the greatest feeling when you know you won the first state championship for your school. And 3 years ago, they were here and lost, so we just wanted to do it this time.
How much did that set the tone in the first 28 seconds in? They probably might have been looking past you a little bit because you didn't have a huge record. But then all of a sudden it's 1-0.
I mean, we knew we needed to score the first goal because their previous game, we knew that they scored and then they just packed the box and defended the whole game and that's how they won. So we knew we needed the first goal fast. That's what we got. And then we just defended and broke up play and won the game.
Yeah, can you talk about the defensive effort, protecting a lead for that long? It's pretty impressive for you guys to be able to maintain that.
Yeah, I think we got more motivated because our forwards were dropping with cramps. We had to have, I don't think our three top forwards were on the field at the same time at any point the second half. So I just I told my center back that I was playing with, I told the right back, the left back what we had to do. We knew we couldn't let them in because if they got a goal, it would be difficult for us to get back. And I don't think there was an overtime in most of these guys. So we did what we had to do.
Yeah. Can you talk about the pressure that you guys withstood, particularly late when they showed a little more urgency in like last 20?
Yeah, so we knew we had to get it up and away. We couldn't give away any corner kicks or free kicks because this team scored a lot of goals in the air. So our main focus was just man marking, and their coach knew that we were playing a stopper-sweeper formation. Mm-hmm. So they had a guy press up on me. Which made it a little difficult, but in the end, we really got a lot of help from those center mids, like you said earlier. Alex Prokopenko, Ori Ratner, if they hadn't done the job that they had done, I don't think we would have been in this game.
You got the early goal, obviously, but the defense really was, that was the whole key, wasn't it, Coach?
Yeah, the defense set the tone, and it's always great when you have so many leaders, and not just the senior we have here in Tamer. We have Elliot Hasty on the right back. He didn't play for half the season because I wasn't so sure about him in terms of knowing him as a player. But when he got his chance, he took it and never came out the right back position. So it really gives you a peace of mind when you know you have a strong back line and you know you can rely on them going when the team is under attack.
Questions?
Congratulations, guys. Well done. Very good.
Pikesville.
Great.